A warm welcome to the 2 days innovation coffee break live from Paderborn. Of course, you know dSPACE as your partner for simulation and validation. And because of this, we of course have a system for supporting you by development and testing of charging components. And therefore, we are focusing on the topic of smart charging today. In the next 10 minutes, I will give you an introduction, slide-based, and also will show you a demo. The demo system, unfortunately, I was not able to put a real electric vehicle in this demo room, and therefore I'm using an electric vehicle simulator. This is based on a script called Rise V2G that generates all the communication messages normally used by an electric vehicle. Those vehicle-to-grid messages are transferred via the smart charge interface box, and then they are provided via CAN-FD to the real-time system. And this Calexo system, this runs a demo model that was also developed by dSPACE based on MATLAB Simulink. But at first, let me tell you what this is all about. The key component to keep a battery electric vehicle alive is the charging system. In our modern society, it will act also as a link between the grid and the vehicle to stabilize the power grid. Soon, we will have a bidirectional energy transfer. To enable this and even more features like authentication for plug and charge, scheduling the charging process, adjusting charging parameters to the desired value of the battery, and several safety aspects in addition to the energy flow, a communication channel is needed. Let's have a look to the worldwide situation. For AC charging, we have the type 1 and type 2 plugs. They already contain a so-called low-level communication based on the adjustment of voltages and a PWM signal with different duty cycles. For the combined charging standard, CCS, two pins for the DC lines were added. On top of the already existing PWM signal, a power line communication is modulated. For high power charging of commercial vehicles, a standard providing up to 3 megawatts is currently under development. Now, let's have a look to the Asian market. Here, the Japanese CHAdeMO and Chinese GBT standards are mostly used. A communication called CHOGI is under development. These Asian standards defined a CAN communication instead of the power line. To work with the standards, the following hardware system is needed. While the CAN communication for the Asian standards can be used by a standard real-time system from dSPACE, we developed the smart charging interface box to handle the power line communication of the other standards. And in addition, we have a full set of software. This is called the software part of the smart charging interface solution. So what is the current situation for an electric vehicle and charging station manufacturers? Both kinds of manufacturers interpret the standards as best as they can and try to verify their implementation by the test with a lot of real charging stations or real electric vehicles. This procedure requires high effort, but still, it does not guarantee the full interoperability because some parameters can change from EVSE to EVSE or from electric vehicle to electric vehicle, even they are from the same brand. We at dSPACE provide our smart charging solution, which simulates the EVSEs and also the EVS depending on the customer requirements. So let's come to the use case I promised at the beginning. Here, the dSPACE system simulates the electric vehicle supply equipment to test the electric vehicle communication controller. This slide shows the ability to do this according all existing standards, while here I modified it slightly to the actual demo. The electric vehicle simulation directly communicates its messages via the smart charging interface box, where they are translated to CAN-FD to be understood by the EVSE simulation model running on this Calexia real-time system. We are the host PC. We can have a look to the system and see what happens. So, now let's do it. So, this is the electric vehicle simulation system, and all the messages that are communicated via the smart charge interface box and then transferred via CAN-FD to the real-time system. And on this real-time system, there runs our charging station model. This was developed in Simulink, and also it could also be changed to some specific requirements. Via the host communication, we get all the data to control desk, but now I think we can start the charging. I will start a script here, and this runs. Here in control desk, you can see the general information about the system, and in the overview, there you can see, okay, there are some messages communicated. And for example, the current demand communication runs quite often, so the electric vehicle is continuously demanding power to be charged. The other layouts I just will tell you a little bit about. For example, the configuration layout. There you can set the low-level communication, what is not part of the demo today. You could also change some or electric fair. So this is also a part not of the demo today. And the slack mechanism and messages for timing manipulation, we also could do this, but not today. I think I will take another cup of coffee in a few weeks to demonstrate it to you then. But now let's have a look to the charging curve. And yes, here it is shown what is expected. We have got the start of charging by measuring the current, the actual voltage. Then the voltage is raised up to the level where the maximum current flows, and the state of charge of the vehicle immediately starts raising. And when it reaches 80%, then the current is reduced until we have got another level, 90%, when we just finish the charging with the remaining current. And when the charging state of charge reaches 100%, then the voltage is switched off. Of course, the current will be reduced as well. And so the charging process is finished. So now let's have a look to a summary. And for the summary, I would like to emphasize the goals we reached by the development of the smart charging solution. At first, we have got a highly customizable communication interface for simulation of the charging partners, the controllers, so whether it's the electric vehicle or the electric vehicle supply equipment, we can simulate both. The system provides full transparency of the communication. So for all the test engineers, it is very convenient to have a very deep look inside the communication and get all the feedback that you need to check what happens here. And by the communication with the CAN-FD interface, it is very easy to integrate the system in your already existing test setup, because CAN-FD is just a standard interface. So I hope you enjoyed this coffee break session for today. If you have got further questions, please get in touch with your sales guys or directly with me, and I will be pleased to answer your questions and assist you by the development and testing of your charging systems. So, have a nice day and goodbye.
dSPACE, your partner in simulation and validation.